The countdown has begun for a sexual assault case accused Prajwal's return. As per the video he released 2 days ago, Prajwal is supposed to return midnight. In the latest development in the case, Prajwal has applied for anticipatory bail in all the three cases, even before returning to India. On the other hand, Home Minister G. Parmeshwara spoke to Times Now and said that SIT will be following the procedure as per law after Prajwal's return.
No, that is what I was told, that he's coming, to India 31st night. So whatever the procedure, SIT will do. If they had to arrest him, they will arrest him. Already, the procedures are being followed by SIT. And they will do the rest of it.
So we've accessed the details of Prajwal's anticipatory bail in which he claims that he is innocent and this has been done against him out of vengeance. Prajwal has sought bail in all the three cases against him. Prajwal Ravana, remember in the video that he released, said that he will come to India today. He'll cooperate in the investigation. And before even he touches down, before he lands, he's filed for bail application in all the three cases. We've accessed the ticket details of Prajwal Ravana. He's going to land in Bengaluru at 12:30 a.m. Prajwal has applied for the anticipatory bail. We have some breaking inputs coming in as well. Now, these are details of Prajwal's stay out of jail plan. His anticipatory bail plea that we've accessed talks about how this is a conspiracy against him. He is claiming innocence through this anticipatory bail application, playing the victim card. Claims he was disturbed and distressed. Rape accused Prajwal Ravana says charges against him are fabricated. He decries a smear campaign against him. Now, the anticipatory bail also says since his rise in politics, this has been done against him out of vengeance, and that he is innocent. The charges against him are fabricated and it's a conspiracy against him. So these are the reasons cited for anticipatory bail by Prajwal Ravana's counsel. We have Neha joining us in the broadcast with more details. Neha, rape accused Mr. Prajwal Ravana first evaded the law. He said that he will come back and then did not turn up. Now that he is going to land, he has made sure that his strategy is in place. Anticipatory bail application says he is innocent. Allegations against him are fabricated and this is nothing but a conspiracy.
Well, that's absolutely right. You know, Swati, just take a look at this anticipatory bail application there. You know, one look at it and you would be able to tell that Prajwal Ravana here is pulling out the victim card. Whether it's from the fact that he says the entire case is fabricated or whether he goes on to say that, you know, this is nothing but a political conspiracy against him and his family, or whether, of course, you know, he's going on to claim complete innocence here and saying that he's shocked that this case has even come up, and most importantly, that he's gone into depression after all of this, and which is why he left the country and this was a planned visit, that he's not evading the authorities. Remember, of course, you know, this is quite crucial here given the fact that there has already been an arrest warrant that's been put out against him. So the chances right now of his anticipatory bail at this point in time looking bleak is what, you know, senior advocates over here in the state of Karnataka are telling us. But having said that, even prior to this, in the video that he had also put out there, he goes on to claim complete innocence there, where he says that, you know, all of this is nothing but a political conspiracy against my family, against me, by my political rivals. And the fact is that there's no truth to any of this. And in light of these developments, that he's gone into depression, that his mental state of mind, you know, did not really permit him to come back prior to today. But of course, whether he returns or not, even tonight, is a big question mark at this point in time. And while the authorities would hope that he does, we'd really have to wait and see if he does return, if he's going to cooperate with the investigating agencies or not.
Right, Neha, stay on with us, because it's not the first time that Prajwal Ravana is playing the victim card. He'd released such videos earlier as well. Let's take a look at what he claims.
ನಾನೆ ಖುದ್ದಾಗಿ ಶುಕ್ರವಾರ ಏನು 31ನೇ ತಾರೀಕು 10 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ SIT ಮುಖಾಂತರ SIT ಮುಂದೆ ಬಂದು ನಾನು ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ಈ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟಿಗೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಸಹಕಾರ ಕೊಡೋ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ನಾನು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಸರಿಯಾದ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ತರ ಕೊಡೋಂಥ ಕೆಲಸನ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ಈ ಸುಳ್ಳು ಪ್ರಕರಣದಿಂದ ಆಚೆ ಬರೋವಂಥ ಕೆಲಸನ ನ್ಯಾಯಾಲಯದ ಮುಖಾಂತರನೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀನಿ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ನಂಬಿಕೆ ನನ್ನಲ್ಲೇನಿದೆ, ಹಾಗೂ ದೇವರ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದ ಮತ್ತು ಜನರ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದ ನನ್ನ ಕುಟುಂಬದ ಆಶೀರ್ವಾದ ನನ್ನ ಮೇಲೆ ಇರಲಿ.
Prajwal Ravana says, I believe in law, I trust the system, the same system that he's been accused of evading and breaking. Times Now has accessed the boarding pass of Prajwal. According to the boarding pass, a business class ticket is booked in Prajwal Revana's name. The flight would be leaving on 30th of May at around 4:35 p.m. according to the Indian Standard Time, and the plane would be arriving the next day at around 12:30 a.m. in Bengaluru. BJP continued to push for a CBI probe in Prajwal case. Former Deputy CM and BJP MLA Ashwath Narayan said that CBI should probe the sexual assault case and that Congress is trying to politicize the issue.
Good that is surrendering and coming back and respecting the law of the land. There is an investigating agency, there is a court. The truth will be revealed. So let him come and let the process of the law go on to bring out the truth. It has really caused real uneasiness in the entire state, and the victims who have been unnecessarily been victimized. For them, Congress people, it is only politics. Congress is nothing but just because of the politics, they are just trying to play the game.
So you heard the allegations coming in that this is nothing but politics as Prajwal continues to evade law. Own party legislators are now slamming in. JDS legislator Samruddhi Manjunath slams Prajwal over the sexual assault case and says that case can't be forgiven and that this is neither money trap or honey trap but self trap. Listen in.
So ivattu yaa ondu ghatane yaaru shamsuvanta ghatane alla adu. ಯಾಕೆಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಮಹಾ ಅಪರಾಧ ಅದು ಆಯ್ತಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಅದೇನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಮನಿ ಟ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಹನಿ ಟ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದೊಂದ್ಸಲ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಟ್ರಾಪ್ ಅದು ಆಯ್ತಲ್ವಾ. ಅವರೇ ಸ್ವಯಚ್ಛಿಂದ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಟ್ರಾಪು. ಕಾನೂನು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ಯಾರು ದೊಡ್ಡವರಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಕಾನೂನು ರೀತಿ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಚಿಕ್ಕವರೇ. ಕಾನೂನು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಐ ಟಿ ಬಂದು ಪೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇವತ್ತೇನು ಅವರು ಇಟ್ಟು ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಶುಕ್ರವಾರ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ 10 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ಎಸ್ ಐ ಟಿ ಬರ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ. ಎಸ್ ಐ ಟಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ಅದೇನು ಎಸ್ ಐ ಟಿನ ಪೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿ, ಮುಂದಿನ ಕಾನೂನು ಕ್ರಮ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಕೈಗೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ಅವರೇ ಭಯಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ, ಸತ್ಯ ಬರಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಅವರೇ ಭಯಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ. ಇವತ್ತು ಏನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಬಹುಶಃ ಏನಾದರೂ ಅವ್ರು ಹೋಗದೆ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರ ನ್ಯಾಯ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಸತ್ಯ ಅಸತ್ಯ ಹೊರಬೀಳ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು.
Neha continues to be with us on the broadcast. Now, so while, you know, the BJP leader Ashwath Narayan says this is a conspiracy hatched by the Congress, it's politicizing the entire issue. JDS MLA says this is nothing but self-trap.
Well, Swati, that's absolutely right. You know, no party here that's stopping from pointing fingers at the other. But now you have a JDS legislator himself who's come out here and said that, you know, Prajwal Revana shouldn't have run away, that he shouldn't have evaded the authorities, and that he himself has landed himself, in fact, you know, in this massive soup now where he has no other option but to get arrested as he lands in the country. You know, of course, the infighting here is quite evident now, even within the JDS. We've seen how none of the JDS legislators or senior leaders so far, you know, have of course gone on to say much on this. We've seen Devegowda there earlier, who came out and put a stern warning for Prajwal to return. We've seen H.T. Kumaraswamy there making an appeal for him to come back. And following all of that, now we're seeing that, you know, this JDS legislator also over here condemning this entire incident. Of course, as far as the investigation goes and whether Prajwal Revana would return right now, remember, of course, he did say that it was his political rivals. He's blaming them for having, you know, released these videos in an attempt to try and align his image, having morphed these videos as well. Who these political rivals are so far, of course, you know, he's not really made it quite clear. But once he possibly returns, you know, there would be more clarity on that.
Right. So once he returns, there'll be more clarity. As of now, he has said in that video, claimed that he will appear before the SIT at 10 a.m. On the 31st of May. According to the details that we've accessed, he's going to land in Bengaluru at 12:30 a.m. Midnight, and then appear before the SID. So far, that's what Prajwal Revana claims. And he's also filed bail application in all the three cases against him. The anticipatory bail application of Prajwal Revana says that he is innocent. These charges are fabricated, has been done against him out of vengeance, and this is nothing but a conspiracy. So playing the victim card there. But like Neha was pointing out, there are some in the JDS who in fact are slamming Prajwal Revana. Some in the JDS, so own legislators themselves saying that this is nothing but a self-trap and that he is evading law. He should not have done that. Let's listen into what Samruddhi Manjunath, JDS MLA, is saying.
So, ಇವತ್ತು ಯಾ ಒಂದು ಘಟನೆ ಯಾರು ಕ್ಷಮಿಸುವಂತ ಘಟನೆ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅದು. ಯಾಕೆಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಮಹಾ ಅಪರಾಧ ಅದು ಆಯ್ತಲ್ವಾ. ಸೊ ಅದೇನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಮನಿ ಟ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಹನಿ ಟ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದೊಂದ್ಸಲ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಟ್ರಾಪ್ ಅದು ಆಯ್ತಲ್ವಾ. ಅವರೇ ಸ್ವಯಚ್ಛಿಂದ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಟ್ರಾಪು. ಕಾನೂನು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು ಯಾರು ದೊಡ್ಡವರಲ್ಲ, ಅಥವಾ ಕಾನೂನು ರೀತಿ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ಚಿಕ್ಕವರೇ. ಕಾನೂನು ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಸ್ ಐ ಟಿ ಬಂದು ಪೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇವತ್ತೇನು ಅವರು ಇಟ್ಟು ವಿಡಿಯೋ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಶುಕ್ರವಾರ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ 10 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ SIT ಬರ್ತೀವಂತ. SIT ಬಂದು ಅದೇನು SIT ಫೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿ, ಮುಂದಿನ ಕಾನೂನು ಕ್ರಮ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಕೈಗೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ಅವರೇ ಭಯಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ, ಸತ್ಯ ಬರಬಿರ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಅವರೇ ಭಯಬಿಡ್ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ. ಇವತ್ತೇನಾಗಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಬಹುಶಃ ಏನಾದರೂ ಅವ್ರು ಹೋಗದೆ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದಿದ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಥರ ನ್ಯಾಯ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಸತ್ಯ ಅಸತ್ಯ ಹೊರಬೀಳ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಅವ್ರು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಅಪರಾಧ ಆಯ್ತು ನಮಗೆ. ಇವತ್ತು ಹೋಗಿದ್ದೆ ಅವ್ರು ಆಚೆ ಹೋಗಿದ್ದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಅಪರಾಧ ಆಯಿತು. ಇವತ್ತು ಬಂದು ಫೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿ, ಫೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಸತ್ಯ ಮತ್ತು ಅಸತ್ಯ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಬಂದು ಫೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಲಿ.
So you heard this JDS MLA who's saying that law is above everything and everybody in front of law is equal. You should have respected law. He also goes on to say that this is not honey trap or money trap. This is a self trap by Prajwal Revanna. We are getting some breaking inputs now. We are given to understand that some... protests against Prajwal Revanna, protests by civil society activists, women activists and others demanding the arrest of Prajwal Revanna has been organized. This Hassan Chalo protest is going to take place at 11 a.m. That's what we're given to understand. So people now hitting the streets protesting against Prajwal Revanna and demanding his arrest. Neha is joining us with more details. Neha, so far we've seen political reactions and political blame game. What we're given to understand now is that members of the civil society, women activists, are going to take part in this protest against Prajwal Revanna. They are demanding his arrest.
Well, Swati, that's right. You know, anger, of course, out in the streets here in the state of Karnataka. We're seeing now women activists and, you know, civil society activists have decided to head this protest here today, demanding that he be arrested. Remember, this comes even as Prajwal Revanna claims that he would be returning tonight. But having said that, of course, one thing that's quite evident is that these activists today who are protesting, you know, are demanding that justice be done to the victims. Whenever there's an influential personality involved, you know, in crimes, we often see that they go scot-free, is what these activists are saying, and which is why today they are demanding that the strictest and the most stringent punishment be given to him, that he be made to abide by the law, much like any of the other citizens of the state, or much like any of the other lawmakers. But with that being said, of course, we really have to wait and see how the response to this protest is today, because, you know, as far as the district of Hassan is concerned, it has known to it has in fact been known to be a stronghold of the JDS here. The clout that the Devegowda family enjoys in the district over here, you know, is something that is something like none other. And having said that, of course, you know, whether people, of course, are going to be, you know, turning up in large numbers to support these protesters today is something that we'll be finding out shortly as we're reaching the district very soon.